I'm Lara, I am 24. I'm studying at MSc Health, Wellbeing and Sustainable Buildings. I have an interdisciplinary background. I did my undergraduate in a degree called Arts and Sciences, also at UCL, where I predominantly majored in History of Art and Architecture and minored in Maths and Sociolinguistics.
My name is Tan, I'm from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, and I'm a mechanical engineer by professions. And I studied in Central London, Polytechnic of Central London, back in 1991. I'm a senior merchant student here. And I enrolled to this master program in health, well-being and sustainable buildings.
I've always been interested in architecture, buildings, all that sort of stuff. I did my undergraduate dissertation on the Maggie Centres and how design architecture plays a role in that palliative care. And from there, I got just really interested in how spaces affect people, and it was something I just wanted to know more about. So I was looking for a master's that would let me learn more about that, and then I actually stumbled across this master's and was quite surprised by how specifically related it was to my interests.
When I'm working in Malaysia, most of the time we're dealing with green building, so-called. And in Malaysia, we consider developing countries. We're concerned on the energy efficiency, water efficiency, but nothing on human-centric. Therefore, I feel that this is a good challenge for me to enroll this program.
It has been tough, but also enjoyable. Given that I'm not an architect or an engineer, I think I had quite a steep learning curve, just because it's a kind of new world. But I have really enjoyed delving into it, and also just being around architects and engineers who have a similar interest. I've really liked collaborating with them and kind of learning with them as I go along.
Well, it was a culture shock for me after being so long and not in the studying situations. For the past 3 months, I get to learn some of the new mode of study, like integrated building design. And first of all, I was overwhelmed with the programs and diverse topics. Well, I have a good support from my peers and as well as some the lecturers. So this is a good challenge.
I'm hoping that after this, I'm going to be able to join a multidisciplinary team that has this kind of active desire to create healthy buildings that really focus on people. Of course, I can't be the building designer per se, but I'm hoping that through my sort of qualitative and quantitative background, research skills, I'll be able to inform those kind of decisions and help create spaces that are better for people in the long term.
In back to Malaysia, the first wave, so-called, is on the building energies, but the second wave probably will be on the health and well-being. So something that I can acquire this experience and transfer some of the knowledge back to Malaysia.
I'd say be prepared to not have a straightforward path, because it's a growing field, so there aren't any clear answers. But that's also something that's really great about it. You kind of feel like you're at the forefront of research that's emerging now, which is really, really cool, to be honest. But it makes it not so straightforward.
This is a new course, and as I mentioned again, health and well-being that you should not neglect, because every one of us talking about the energy efficiency, something is a good impact to the health, you know, by applying some of the techniques and those methodologies. I'm sure a lot of students will benefit from these programs.
I mean, it's a really great thing to have available for this master's. I'm not so sure what I would have done if I didn't have it. So it has lifted a burden, definitely. And yeah, I would just strongly advise applying for it. Why not?